I'm Cherie Barber from Renovating for Profit, and in this video I'm going to teach you how to tile paint properly. Now there's hundreds of thousands of old bathrooms right across the globe that are structurally in great condition but cosmetically tired, and a big part of those bathroom problems is the old floor and wall tiles. So the good news is that you don't have to rip your old tiles out. A lot of you are going to be dealing with these sorts of tiles, feature tiles that were very prevalent about 20, 30 years ago. Certainly we had our fair share of terracotta, which looked great 30 years ago, doesn't look so great today. With a few licks of paint, you can make those old tiles look new again. Before you apply any tile paint, what I recommend is that you fill any divots, any little cracks in your grout with either new grout or polyfiller. You can see here some little bits that are missing, just press those in. Obviously wait for that to dry before you apply any tile paint. Looking good. Next step is surface cleaning. So we need to give our tiles in our old bathroom a super good scrub. I can't stress enough, good surface preparation. Okay, next step is to sand your tiles. Now I know you're thinking, what? Sand my bathroom tiles? You absolutely need to sand them. So grab your mouse sander, sand away. Now what I have to do is just clean it again. I have to make sure that all that dust from sanding is completely clear off the tiles. Tiles have to be squeaky clean. Beautiful. Once your tiles are completely dry, you're ready for your priming, your undercoat. And what I recommend is that you start with the brush in your hand, you do your grout lines first, so quickly just skim down your grout lines. You can see I'm moving fairly fast, and we just don't want any brush marks. So as soon as you can, in comes your roller, okay? It's almost like you're feathering with the roller. Now my paint primer is dry. I need to sand it again with our 240 grit wet and dry sandpaper again. And that's just to make sure that there's no lint in it whatsoever in between coats. So it's a quick sand, you can literally do your whole bathroom in about 30 minutes, if not less. It's definitely not extensive sanding in between coats. Wipe it over, make sure all your surfaces are completely clean. Now we're ready to tile paint. So coat your roller, but don't put a lot of paint on it. Make sure you tap the end so any excess comes off. Okay, start with your grout lines first. Follow through with your mini foam roller. Do a zigzag pattern just to get good coverage and good adhesion on your tiles. Now I'm going to follow through in one direction from top to bottom. Don't press too hard on the roller. If you press too hard, you'll get paint marks like that, and that will show up under your final coat. So just nice soft approach, you can roll that out. So final roll. You can see that's pretty flawless and it looks pretty professional even just with one coat. So it's getting late in the day. I've waited 6 hours for my first coat of tile paint to dry. So all you do is you simply repeat the process. You just give it a very light sand, again, not heavy-handed, very light. Wipe it down with a clean cloth, make sure it's super clean. Final coat, I'm pretty excited. And all you do is you simply repeat the process. Grab your paintbrush, put some paint on your roller, and away you go. Remember to roll out those paintbrush marks. I'm just getting good coverage here. The devil in the detail is that final roll, making sure it's from top to toe. So I'm almost finished on my final coat. The manufacturers say allow 6 hours to dry. I always leave it overnight. So come in the next day, fine to use your bathroom. The tile paint does take 1 week to fully cure. So in that first week, be super careful with hard knocks because they will damage your tile paint. So there you go, that's the finished product. You can see it looks great. The good news is tile paint is super cheap. It's within the skill level of literally every homeowner. And it's a product that you're going to consistently use if you're a renovator on the budget. Get in there, try it, all the best with your projects.